Let us pray. O God of hope, inspire us with the message of this day. Help us be patient as we worship, and trust that we may hear the angels' message and make room in our hearts for the saving news.
Do you like the dark? Have you ever been afraid of the dark? Imagine if the whole world was filled with darkness. What if our hearts were filled with darkness? When we think of light in our hearts, what does that mean?
Reading from John 8:12. Again, Jesus spoke to them saying, "I am the light of the world. Whoever follows me will never walk in darkness, but will have the light of life." The word of the Lord. With the birth of Jesus, the world knew a different kind of light.
Before Jesus was born, God's people heard the prophet's message from God that Jesus would be born in Bethlehem. Caesar Augustus' census helped fulfill that prophecy because Joseph and Mary had to return to Joseph's homeland.
In those days, a decree went out from the emperor of Rome that all the world should be registered. All people went to their own towns to be registered. Joseph also went from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to the city of David, called Bethlehem, because he was descended from the house and family of David.
When we remember to do Advent, we behave in a peaceful manner as Jesus would.
The Bethlehem candle also represents peace. It means standing up for what is right. This goes for adults and even for kids. Be the light to people who walk in darkness.
The shepherd's candle is also called the candle of joy. We can also look at the candle of unexpected blessings. Mary was blessed by God in a very unexpected way. From Luke 1:46, Mary said, "My soul magnifies the Lord, and my spirit rejoices in God my Savior, for he has looked down on this servant girl. His mercy will go on forever and ever."
You see, with God, nothing is impossible. It's not possible to be impossible.
Unexpected blessings, unforeseen moments that give us reason to rejoice. We don't see them coming, and sometimes we don't know we're in them until they pass and we reflect on them. Sometimes unexpected blessings happen and we miss them because we don't have our eyes and heart open to the moment.
The final candle is the angel's candle, the candle of love. John 3:16. For God so loved the world that he gave his only son, so that everyone who believes in him may not perish, but may have eternal life.
Eternal. What exactly does that mean? Here are a few synonyms: everlasting, unending, timeless, forever. That's what God's love is.
Let us pray. Dear Lord, today we pray for the people who are sad and unwell. We pray for the people who are torn in areas of the world. We are thankful for the good things we have. We pray for family and friends. And God, we pray that we may live in the light and that Jesus is in our world. Christ is coming. Amen.